Hey guys, this is Tim from Tim's Electronics Lab and welcome back to a new video. Now in this video we're going to be taking a look at what's inside this box. This box, well, the contents of the box are described as PC repair tools, one piece with a weight of 0.05 kilograms, which is not correct. The tracking app I used showed that the weight was around 1.2 kilograms and it should contain a value of $1. I already know that the value is not correct. Maybe it took so long to arrive because the label was cracked. The box was stuck in the distribution center for quite some time, but nevertheless it's here. And whilst I'm opening this rather questionable box, I mean, I can feel the box that's inside this box through here. Let me tell you about a new project idea that I've been promoting on the channel for a while now. That project idea is about creating my own Linux embedded system. Based of some kind of microcontroller, STM32 for example, creating a PCB with all the components, creating a custom compiler, and explaining why I made certain design choices. Excuse me there. I think that will be quite a nice video series to make, quite an interesting video series as well, because I will really go in depth onto hardware design and PCB design, and it will, well, I think I will need to put in all the PCB design experience that I have to create a working system. So please let me know down below if you like that idea. And well, yeah, basically if you want me to create such a video series, I think it will be around 10 to 20 maybe videos. So yeah, please let me know down below. Well, ta-da! This is inside the box. A digital microscope. Yeah, you know, I think it's quite clear what I will be using this for. But first, let me take some pictures for the thumbnail. So, all the socials are done. I ordered a microscope. Well, why? Well, I didn't have one. And also for that Linux project that's maybe going to come, I needed a microscope that was able to actually show me a detailed view of the QFP packages that I'm going to solder. So let's take it out of the box. Oh, there's a screen protector over it. A user manual, portable LCD microscope. Main parameters, pixel HD 12 megapixel. Display screen 7-inch HD display. Well, you take a look for yourself. Magnification 1 to 1200 times. Distance between object 10 millimeters to infinity. Yeah. Plug-in or built-in ultra lithium battery. Lots of system languages, but no Dutch, unfortunately. Significant improvements. Advantage 1. Vertical microscopes have an important drawback because you miss it's easy to lose sight of the details of the object due to reflection. Oh, you can adjust the angle. Well, that's that's really cool. Well, this is the first time that I have encountered a user manual that's actually readable, and well, that's actually contains some useful information about the product. Well, let's get it. It's quite funny that it's only listing microscope. Now I am a little bit concerned. Yes. I was concerned there that this was the only thing that they sent me, which obviously is not all that it's needed. Oh, the button feels quite solid, which is quite nice, because I've tested some microscopes. Oh, this is not good. This is a UK adapter. Well, that's unfortunate. Well, I was saying that I've tested some microscopes, and whenever you rotated this button and move the microscope around, it just sagged. I don't think that that's a proper word, but it went back down. It wouldn't stay on the position that you set it at. So let me take another thumbnail photo. This microscope doesn't seem to have issues with that, and well, that's very fortunate. We do need to assemble it, but that's all right. This has been packed quite tightly together. Now, one of the reasons I picked this one and not the other one, let's get rid of this box, is that this microscope had an aluminium base, which is better than plastic, because this will stay put once you put it on your desk. And well, it gives a greater quality feeling overall. Yeah, I guess that you'll have to tighten it. The threads aren't matched and you need to tighten it like so. This looks like it needs to go into something or somewhere. That's, well, it does feel really steady. I don't think that this knob will adjust the tension of that the angle adjuster. I'm always wondering how did they put this. Well, I guess it's these knobs and then they can remove it, but that was quite funny to actually see. Yeah, of course. And you can lock it with this thing. It will push a plastic thingy into the metal and yeah, it will hold it for you. Oh, this is nice attention to detail. Those are plastic. Well, it's better than just metal on plastic. I thought for a second that these were rubber cushions, that it wouldn't damage. Ooh, I'm all greased up. I think they greased the teeth on the aluminium stand there. Whoa, that felt really, really messy. Well, when I was there in my shelf, I got another 5-volt adapter out of my drawer, a generic 5-volt 3-amp with micro USB, obviously. Otherwise, it isn't going to work. And I'll get in touch with AliExpress, because I definitely ticked the EU button and not the UK button. So, well, the grease is over here on the back side. Well, let's attach the actual screen and camera, of course. I was expecting it to completely fall down, but there seems to be a little edge over here, which is fine. But so there is no power. I think I did opt for the battery powered option, but I guess that we'll have to charge it. So let me go connect the charger. Well, the micro USB port is behind the... Oh, it came loose. It's behind the microscope. It's over here. It's... Oh. You actually need to use these. Oh, it's quite tight in there. Well, this is kind of a bad product design. It does fit in the end, but it's a quite a tight fit. So let's inject it into the power. There you go. Let's lay it down for a second. 1080p full HD. Well, that's what we want. Let me adjust the... Oh, that doesn't make sense. Yeah, this is the focus. Oh, wow. Let's focus on my hand. Oh, I've got dirty hands. Alright, so the menu. Resolution. Oh. Okay. Yeah, full HD. Cyclic record, high dynamic range, HDR. Now, you gotta be kidding to have HDR on here. Exposure. Well, that's cool that you can adjust it. It's not applied whilst you select it, so you need to press OK every time you found a new or you want to view a new setting. I think that this is date stamp. Yeah, this allows you to add the date stamp to the video. Nice, really nice that you can turn this off. It's really, really nice. The D menu or D button cycles you through to the other page. LCD brightness, this is LCD screensaver. So I guess that's for auto power off, 5 minutes frequency. I guess that, yeah, this is just a refresh. Well, 60 hertz, better. Auxiliary to the line. What the hell is that? Auxiliary to the line. Press OK, what happens? Nothing. Oh, well, I think something. No. What the hell is this? Well, language, date, time. Oh, you can set the date, time. Well, it's made in 2020. It's 16. Please. Oh, this allows you to format the SD card. Default setting. Well, I won't be pressing that. Version. Well, this is the version. Oh, it's made in July. July the 29th. Cool. I was having a vacation back then. So, well, yeah, this is. Oh, you can switch. What's this? This is recording. Oh, I guess that this is the menu where you can replay your... And it says that it's connected to the wall. That's actually... So... It looks like there isn't a battery in here. You hold it to shut it down. But the thing shows that it's charging the LED. But, well... Let's actually get a micro SD card and let's record something so we can see what the quality is like. So I got a micro SD, 8 gigabytes SDHC, and the micro SD card slot is right next to the power adapter, but let me... You need to insert it with the contacts facing the screen. And that's quite a smooth feeling. I saw some other microscopes online that featured a spring that will, well, almost kills you when you actually eject your micro SD card. So let's actually put something under the microscope and see what it looks like. So I've got a generic 12 volts to computer ATX power supply plug. Let's actually view the PCB under the microscope. All right, so let me press the record button. Oh, it has digital zoom as well. Let's check the user manual. In video mode, when the video flashcards format, ooh, it automatically removes your videos from the SD card. And power on the video recorder turned automatically, if any. Okay, so it will automatically record when something moves. Photograph mode. Ah, this is the menu of the, let me show this to you. This is the menu of the capture, the image mode. Resolution. Yeah, we can go up, continue shooting, quality, fine. Corner ISO, oh wow. That's really cool. Yeah, this is just generic things. So, yeah, it's not touchscreen. Well, I was actually hoping that it would take a picture whenever I pressed something, but it doesn't look like it. So, well, yeah, I guess that we'll have to check the SD card's contents to see if we actually did something. Isn't the SD card coming out anymore? Now it's not coming out anymore. Now luckily this is a rather cheap SD card, but nevertheless it's... Oh, it's what the... There you go. It gets caught under the case, which is rather interesting. Now let's power it up again. But the main thing was that we still don't have any images or videos on the card. So, resolution. No, I just want to start a recording. I didn't talk to you about the LED brightness. It's over here. And there's a little slider that you can use to adjust the brightness, which is quite handy. And it will automatically adjust the ISO and such for you, which is also quite handy. But what isn't so handy is that I still don't know. Maybe we need to format the SD card. Well, let's just format it then. Hey, we needed to format the SD card. So now it's recording. There you go. So let's try to get it a little bit. It feels kind of rubbery, but it's okay. But it does get real close. And yeah, the shine is real. So let's tilt it, which will presumably fix this problem according to the manual. But it's out of focus now. Well, that's actually quite good. That's actually really good. Even with the LED off, it's... Oh yeah, I've got studio lights all around me, so it's no surprise that there's enough light. Clear the dust away a little. So let's zoom in. And let's adjust the focus. Oh yeah, this is really good. You can get in real close with your, where am I? Oh, over here, soldering iron like this. Yeah, don't look at my soldering iron, it's rather crusty and rather nasty. But oh, this is really, really good. And of course you can zoom out all the way up top, and then you really need to adjust the focus again. Well, let's zoom in all the way. Go. Let's see what the focus will be like. Something is getting warm inside here, I think. Well, wow. Wow, this is cool. This is really cool. You can still see the flux left from the that's left on the pins from the factory. Wow. Look at this. I'm doing this with my finest tweezer. I mean, let's blow it away. Where was I? There you go. Now, obviously, there is no sound being recorded. It's a microscope, not a recording thing. But I'm surprised by the quality. I mean, you can get in real close. Well, let's grab my toothbrush and try to clean it. So I'm just going to use Pearl. That's a glass cleaner, but it contains isopropyl alcohol. Yes. Wow. Look at the detail. Look at how fine those teeth brush are. Hello, I'm inserting the toothbrushes things into the little vias over there. This is really cool. This is really cool. Yeah, something they might have might still want to improve is that the did I scrape away PCB over there? No. Oh, it's just not properly reflowed, I guess. Is that the text that's on the screen is not having shadows. So if you put something white on the screen, so for example this silk screen, I cannot see the 1080p FHD that's up top anymore. It's being blanked out by the white of the silk screen. Of course the connector. Let's take a look at the LED. It doesn't really stay put, so let me grab something. Let's put it a bit of, I guess that you call this blue tack, but we call this kneedgum. It's a foldable eraser, quite literally translated. The caps are loose, man, damn. So let's push this on here. Let's adjust the angle of attack. And the focus. No, I can't go down anymore. Well, that's. Oh, you can see the bond wires of the LED over here. That's really cool. That's really. So there are two. I think that these are. I think that this is a green one and this is a orange one. Or maybe they're both green. According to the, well, why is this not, oh, I think that this is connected through there. Really cool. So this is two LEDs in one package. Let's take a look at something that you're more familiar with. That is my YouTube logo. Well, on my phone, obviously. So let's put this back down. Let's turn off the LED because the thing is already emitting light by itself. And let's put the microscope straight over my phone. Let's start from a little bit higher so we can see what we're actually focusing on. Oh, there we go. There is my logo. My screen is a little dirty. So let's zoom into the, let's zoom into the transistor, shall we? Oh, this is the maximum I can focus. So this is the maximum that I can zoom. Wow. This is the really cool. You can also see the LEDs over here. Well, this is black, obviously, because I've got the black theme enabled. Let's put some light on there to see what happens. No. So you can see the individual pixels. That's really cool. That is really cool. Let's go to my camera over here. It's a little dirty. Where is it? Ah, there you go. There's the infrared sensor, the proximity sensor. There is my camera. Well, we do need a little bit of light for this. And I'm going to put it. So let's focus. I think that the light's too much. Yeah, you can really see the lens. Well, there is one thing that I still want to show you, or my telephone being the OnePlus 6T. It is having the fingerprint reader behind the screen. It should be around here. Let's clean this first. Turn off the telephone. Let's zoom out first. I know that if you shine enough light on it, that you can see it. But obviously, it's hard to find. So let me grab another flashlight and we'll try to locate it. Because I know it's there, obviously. All right, thanks. It lights up. Where do you light up? Over there. So there is our victim. Under there. Let's keep that in focus. I'm not sure if you'll be able to actually see it. If we shine some light on there. Yeah, I can see it from over here. Yeah, there you go. You can see the shape quite vaguely. Let's use the built-in light to light it. Can we? No, we can't see it with the built-in light. Now there's one thing I still want to put under the microscope, but I gotta clean it first. What is that, you may ask? Well, I've got this really nice ink pen and I want to see and we can somehow see the ink flowing through here. I just turned on my room light, but it isn't really helping. So let's insert the ink filament and let's watch the pen while I squeeze it a little. Let's put a piece of paper at the end of the pen. See if it puts ink on there. It does. Wow. But where does the ink come from? Yeah, in between, I know. I was expecting you to see. Oh, there's a little hole at the end of the pen. Let me zoom into that. You can barely see it, but over here, there's a little hole, and that's where the ink comes out of, apparently. So that's really cool. Before I leave, let's stop the recording. It has started over a couple of times. I guess because there is a time limit. I'll check the time limit in the video. So, and move to photo mode. And let's take a picture. There you go, the resolution is 4032 by 3024. And let's get one up close for some components. Well, I was always fascinated about the way that these diodes look. You've got, let me switch to recording mode again. Oh yeah, you can view them back. 5 minutes. That's the recording limit. And they end up as MOVs, so let's record. I was always fascinated about these rings over here and how they would be soldered to the PCB. So yeah, that's just what I wanted to show you. Do I suggest you to purchase this? Well, this microscope is really good, actually. I'm surprised. Well, it has some quirks here and there. I mean, the SD card is definitely a big disappointment that it goes in so rough. And the USB port is also, yeah, quite tightly packed to the body of the screen. But once you overcome that, it definitely is worth your money. And well, I'll have to take a look and see the footage at the quality of the image, but I'm sure that you've already made your decision if the quality is good or not, because you just saw the recording that I made in an overlay. So yeah, well, I really thank you guys for watching. Well, there's still one thing actually that I'm might have to do, and that's to check if there is a battery inside here or not. Just out of curiosity. Oh, let's eject the SD card first. Yeah, it gets caught under the housing. And you need to pull it away from there and then it will eject. Let's open this up real quick. Alright, so I guess that are all the screws. Let's take this apart very gently, because I'm not sure how the mechanism is attached. No, there's no battery. I think that's where the battery is supposed to go. Over there. Yeah, and up top you can see the battery connector. So, no battery. Oh well. Well, you can just attach your power bank to this thing and you'll have a battery, because it's USB powered. So that's, yeah, well, would be nice if it had one, but. So I'm not going to take this open any further, because I don't want to damage the focusing system. I'm not sure how it's created and attached, but I think there should be a video on YouTube about somebody taking this thing apart. So, whilst I'm screwing in the screws, please don't forget to leave your comments down below on this microscope, the quality of the video, the quality of the photos, but also on that Linux project that I had in mind. Please let me know if you fancy such a project on my channel. Personally, I think that it's going to be a really cool project, and I'm really looking forward to designing the things and soldering it. And well, I'm not sure if there will be any programming. But yeah, there will be in the sample programs that I'll be shipping, between quotes, with the board. I'm not sure if I'll sell some assembled boards on the internet, because that's the whole purpose of the video, to learn you how to create your own Linux development board and Linux embedded system board. But yeah, well, let's give it a quick test before we exit and end the video, to see that everything is still working. Well, maybe the USB port needs to be worn in a couple of times. So, focusing still works. Yes, focusing still works. Well, this one. That's it then for this video. Thank you all for watching, and as I said, leave your comments down below on the Linux project and the microscope that I just bought, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye! Hey guys, this is Tim. I hope you liked that video. If you want to see more, please make sure to subscribe. You can also share the video with your friends and hit that like button. I'll see you in the next one.